Okay, lab notes, formulas, financial records, research into hearing loss, human experimentation and trials?
That looks like cash payouts to volunteers.
I recognize some of these jerks. They're all known gang members.
So Langstrom was doing medical experiments on criminals.
You're crowding me.
Miss Gordon. The holo imaging system is back online as of this morning.
Perfect timing, Alfred.
Hey, I forgot how sweet your setup was, Babs.
It's ancient, but it'll do for now.
You and Master Bruce are the only two people in the entire world who would consider the Belfry systems ancient.
While researching Langstrom, I also called up all we've got on our party crasher.
Talia al Ghul. She was a match for Master Bruce in more ways than one. Her presence in Gotham is concerning.
So is the fact that she torched her old man's body. We sure that was Ra's al Ghul?
His DNA was all over the weapon she left behind.
I wonder why she didn't take a chance and use a Lazarus pit to revive him.
Well, Batman would just find Talia and ask her himself.
Good thinking.
Yeah, I can double-check Talia's kunai for trace materials that we can track.
You should also hit the streets. Find out if anyone had any beef with Langstrom.
Sweet. Time to bust some skulls.
We got new intel for the evidence board.
I can't get over what Talia did to her father's body back there.
Good riddance. Going in a Lazarus pit once is hell. Who knows what a thousand dunk would have done to him.
So you think it really was a show of mercy?
Oh, she was putting on a show all right. But I doubt it was mercy.
Seems like Dr. Langstrom was into some pretty wild stuff. I wish he was still alive.
I'd ask him what the heck he was thinking.
Montoya stuck it to Commissioner Kane back at the police station.
Yeah, why do you think Dad liked her so much?
Because she was fiercely loyal to him.
No, because she wasn't afraid to call people on their shit, including him.
Physical and mental preparation go hand in hand. Here, we can train the mind to prepare the body. But it requires deep focus. Let go of your grief and concentrate on my voice.
Anything you want to share?
Okay. I guess there are a few things I could tell you.
Thanks for the tip. Tell me what you know.
This is awkward, but I'm feeling given. Here's what I got.
Interesting.
I expect no less.
Oh!
You're better than that.
I know just what I'll do if they come back. You should leave, Robin. I'm not letting you get away. Get back here. Wait, he's not here anymore. Him.
Scared? You should be.
He's here. Oh, he's here.
You'll surpass even me.
Chaos erupted at Gotham University after a local gang known as the Freaks vandalized and set fire to multiple buildings. Police made numerous arrests after the blaze tore through the campus library, built more than 150 years ago. Irreplaceable collections valued in the millions were destroyed, and at least one man, believed to be an employee of the university, was found dead at the scene. Authorities have not said whether the man's death is connected to the fire. The victim's name has not been released, pending a forensic investigation. This is Noor Rashid with GCN.
Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night, expecting Bruce to call me for help. And then I remember. I thought it might have been one of you calling just now. I was worried. Old habits, I suppose.
I get that way sometimes, too. You were always looking out for Bruce. We both were. It's hard to imagine a Robin without a Batman. But I guess it's up to me to figure that out.
And I'll be here to support you. Gotham is in good hands.
Bruce never mentioned Langstrom's name to you?
Not once, Master Richard. He had a variety of cases he kept from me, but never one this important.
We'll figure it out.
Of that, sir, I have no doubts. And we will do it together.
I added new intel to the board.
Gotham is mourning the loss of millionaire philanthropist Bruce Wayne, who perished earlier this month after his home collapsed into a sinkhole. Colonel Jacob Kane, CEO of Kane Industries and Wayne's uncle, gave the eulogy during a funeral at Gotham Cemetery. Though Wayne's contributions were at times overshadowed by public antics, he was a prominent philanthropist and pillar in Gotham's business community. Wayne chaired the Martha Wayne Foundation, and he was often lauded for growing his family business into one of the city's most valuable.
The others tell me that the bat signal is down in lockup.
In evidence. Alongside stuff from Dent and Ra's al Ghul. As if he was the same as them.
Unfortunately, to many on the Force he was. But never to the ones who mattered.
Oh, Alfred. Yeah,